Okay, guys, haven't posted a video in a while. Got our different setup here. Got a different radio that got gifted for me from a very, very generous ham. I'm not going to get into... Well, his name's Gary. Awesome dude. Let's see, we got a 757. Got the speaker slash power supply and the tuner. It's not blinking, it's just LEDs. But it's definitely not blinking. They're about as close to new as you can get, honestly, for something that's probably close to 30 years old. Beautiful, beautiful. So that's upgrade recently. Also have a... Got gifted a 736, which I'm probably going to take off the bench here and get in the closet. Box up, get in the closet or something. I don't want this to get scratched up. This is like basically a work of art, as they say to some people, because it's, you know, top technology. I know it's older technology, but it's a monster. Very capable. Very, very capable. But... You know, it's older technology, but still works. And that's something I need a lot of antenna array to get good use on. So we're kind of put it away for right now and start working. So this is going to be... I'm getting this on eBay, which I didn't know until after I clicked buy, after I went through him and Han for a while. It's from Cable Experts. LMR equivalent, so low loss. Things probably like 45 pounds. Maybe a little more for 150 yards. Or feet. 150 feet, sorry. The store is somewhat local. It's over Western New York, Lockport, New York. Small store. It's one of the few ham stores in New York. So I honestly didn't realize it was them. I was looking at prices. I went to different websites. And I somehow skipped them. And I hit buy. And I was like, wait. That's familiar. And I got online. I was like, oh, I know them. So I bought it. I think it was Saturday or Sunday. And got mailed out Monday. Came here. Now it's Wednesday. So very fast. They shipped it out. Really, really good deal. And go on to their site, rwantennastore.com. If you're a New Yorker or any, it's a mom pop shop, which we definitely at this point in time, we need support compared to some of the big guns. Like Cable Experts, I've seen them, and this is actually a better price than what I could get at Cable Experts. And I looked at the same thing and everything, that's why I ended up getting it. But I mean, they're a big company, a lot, you know, the Gigaparts, which I've gotten stuff from Gigaparts before, and I'm very happy with a lot of the other stores. But if you can support like a local ish, try to. They're the ones that are hurting right now. So this new rig, the Azu. I got some stuff ordered for cables, and I got a plug for like a foot switch for it, a PTT, but it's like a foot switch you can use in your hand or your foot, so make it a little bit easier for getting in here and rag chewing. I get the mic right up in my face. I'm not sure if I'm going to keep this microphone. This is literally, I think it was like around $20. I liked the whole... Boom, and it's got like a shock cord mount. But I'm not, we'll see how that does. See how it sounds. I'll run it off. Like, I think I have a dummy load. I do have a dummy load. Yeah, I have a dummy load working low until I probably can get my shortwave radio and just check the audio and see how it sounds. Got kind of a, I don't have that bassy of a voice, so even cheap microphones usually work pretty good for me, and I don't have to worry about spending tons. Usually I just use the standard. I think this is just like a backup microphone or something. But at least I had something to work with starting off. So what we're doing, this coax out here. Let's get out here. We're going to run the back garden. The back garden depends where you're from. Out here somewhere. Around in there, clearance all the trees. That's my apple tree, maple tree, a couple other ones, weeping willow, It likes to have branches fall everywhere. Somewhere in here, I can't plot out kind of a somewhat safe distance for it's gonna be a DX Commander Light. We're gonna run 40, 20, 10. I can worry too much about 6 at this point. Let's see, I just have my not this is basically emergency put up. A little portable 40 meter on dipole. It's going down a tree there and a tree it's over there. It was up a lot higher, a lot better angle, and it's been extra windy, so couldn't keep any of that stuff going, but oh well. And there's my old right here. The wire I use for years and years and years. Probably the past like 10 years I use it in here. Long wire with a big old tuner. Had good luck, but I want to get some more, something I can just hook up, not worry about, simple. You know, not worry about a tuner. Is it going to tune? Is it icy? I want it to something that'll be resonant and plug and play, and all my power goes to the wire. Obviously, I can kind of dig, like, running low power, so that's kind of my goal now. Once I get the DX Commander up and get everything all set so I can just have a nice, strong, solid signal without pushing, you know, full power, hard landing power. So then when I want to push power, you know I can really get out there, especially if there's something major going on. But even then, I mean, 10 watts, 5 watts, 10 watts, if you have a nice setup, and that's my goal there, to go vertical instead of horizontal, get rid of a lot of my noise from the house, from the TVs, and all different, you know, wall warts and stuff plugged in. I'm hoping it cuts out a lot of that, which I believe it will, just from using a shortwave radio around the house and go in the backyard. It quiets down dramatically, get the noise floor lower so I can actually hear other people and hopefully get heard. But we'll see. It's a project, so that'll be, I don't know how long it's going to take. It's coming from, the DX Man, it's coming from Great Britain. So it's going to take a bit. But I'm sure when Colin, he's got stuff going on with shutdown over there too. So doing what he can. So when I get it, I get it. Faster the better, of course. Because that's we want everything yesterday. It's Americans. But for the most part, pretty happy. Pretty excited, I should say. Not just happy, but just trying to get things moving up again. Instead of just kind of half-assing it. We'll see. Get more long-term ideas. I think have a offset dipole I'm going to put up. They'll cover like 80, I think 86, and I'm not sure everything basically in between. Might go that in a slightly different direction. Maybe up in that big old tree if I can get it up high enough. I'm not sure. I'll wait until the expander, then I'll get that up. And I gotta move my 2 meter 440 antennas. Will probably be moved back here to the corner of the deck or somewhere back here, because where it's at now, it's no good. And I just have, where's the cable? Cheap, really cheap cable on it, so I'm losing most of my signal. So that's what I'm working on, just upgrading stuff that I haven't upgraded in a long time. You know, because I'm sure once I get this buried and set, I don't have to mess with it for. I mean, hopefully it's American made and it's made for bearing and stuff. Hopefully, not for a very, very long time. And I'm sure maybe we'll get some cheap conduit. Yeah, I could probably get some cheap conduit to run it through, just help it that much more last longer. Guess I have to pull it out or check it or whatever. So it should be exciting. Try to get some more videos up. When I get really going on there, a little more rag chewing, which I enjoy. And some, you know, chasing some DX. Like everybody likes, of course. That's about it. And like I said, this, I'm curious how this will sound on a radio if you adjust it properly. Now, if this hand mic sounds okay, maybe I can get this sucker to sound decent. You know, have a nice, rich sound to it. But we'll see. I mean, I don't really want to spend another, you know, 100, 200 bucks on like a Heil microphone or something on that lines, or Shure or something like that. But we'll see if I have to, We will, or just stick with a hand microphone right now if it doesn't sound, if it sounds horrible. That's all. That's my update. I haven't updated in a while. That's about it. Hopefully, we'll get some more videos up, especially this summer. And I know I got my micro BX or micro Bit X, sorry, rigged. I got a couple batteries, and that's actually my 40 meter antenna I use for that. So if we get out camping or something, I want to try to throw that in a tree. And if we can get camping this year, which I hope we can, and out, and the wife's out hanging with her friends to get a run a little quick QRP work, which I do love. And that's all. We'll see you guys later, and thanks for watching.